James, that's called Wanted, and in the studio with us tonight we have the chaps who are actually behind that particular single. Hello, James themselves, welcome in tonight.
Hello.
Nice to have you in. Now, you're not actually strangers to this part of the world, because you were playing the Ritzy, the Beat Club, up in Newcastle the other day, weren't you?
That's right.
Yeah. How did it go up there? Have a good time?
Well. We enjoyed it very much.
Good response?
Yeah, it was, actually, yeah.
And we were talking before, it's a bit of a blur at the moment. You're really overworked and very heavy workload.
CBS have got the whip out at the moment.
Yeah. So it's not such a glamorous life. I mean, obviously, a lot of people think, you know, once you start making records, there's tons of dosh coming in, and, you know, you live a life of Riley. It's not like that. It's all hard work.
All wrong. No money and lots of work.
Oh. And the flu to boot.
Yeah. Yeah, Christian.
Are you suffering as well?
Yeah, at the moment.
I think we've all gone down with that. So let's just run around the actual roles and things. I mean, Christian, you're the guy who puts together the vocals and things.
That's right.
Yeah, and we also have Neil in as well.
I do all the keyboards and all that bit of it.
And Ray?
I'll do as little as possible.
make the tea and things.
That's right, I do make a lot of tea. Yeah, no, I'll play the guitar.
Yeah. And how did you all sort of meet? How did you get started?
Well, it's a fairly long story, but we'll sort of condense it down, I think. But basically, it was all in a group called Pride.
Mm-hmm.
The original Pride, which had Sade in it, she came down as a backing singer. And after we played around the country a little bit, Sade went on and to forge her own career. She took some of my songs with her, one of them being Smooth Operator. And after that, I completely reformed the band, Pride. I kept the same name. And from then, I sort of auditioned about 80 singers, and obviously Christian Knight is the one that shone through the whole lot of them, like, you know, as a star. So, and he came down, and that was it. And from that, we auditioned some more people, and that's when Neil came along as the wizard keyboard player. And and then from Pride, we played around the country as the second Pride, but a lot of sort of record companies who really said, "Oh, you've got something there. We can't quite put our finger on what it's missing, you know, there's too many," because we had, like, we augmented it with a brass section on stage as well, they wasn't actually in the band, but probably looking at it looks like it was about
a football team. It was about nine on stage at times, which was very messy.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
So what about live work and stuff like that? When are we going to get to see you out and about?
We're hoping to tour in April, which will coincide with the album, which is half completed already, and it'll probably be about a 12-date tour. I'm really looking forward to that.
Are you going to try and, I don't know, support somebody or...?
No, we're just hopefully headlining ourselves. Yeah.
Good stuff. Now, what about, I mean, you're a good-looking bunch of lads. That can always lead to problems in the music industry. Obviously, record companies perhaps sometimes try to sell you on your image alone. You obviously want to make it as musicians and not just on image? I mean, does that cause you problems at all?
Well, it doesn't cause us any problems. The problems are caused by the media or the record company themselves.
Yeah.
We do say it's the material and the songs first.
Because you can get pigeonholed as a particular sort of, you know, teeny bopper.
Yeah, very much
group.
So, but it's difficult because we know which songs we've written. I mean, we've got a huge catalogue of songs yet to be recorded. Because we've been together for about 4 years in different capacities. So we know that we've got a large variety and diversity of songs, but it's just because the public have only heard Wanted and Now Could Have Told You So, at least now they've heard two completely different songs, one being a ballad and one being an up-tempo 6/8 number.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but until they hear the album and then all the other tracks, they aren't going to obviously realise our potential. They'll mm-hmm. just think we're capable of doing what they've heard. And obviously you can only just judge a band on their past performance, what they've done.
And also, because we've got quite strong songs, or we feel we have, we don't, you know, being tipped for the top or whatever, but we feel we're going to be a band for the 90s and not just 1990. I don't think we're the kind of band that will just be a fad. I think, you know, we'll outgrow the teen thing, and we, because of the material, we think it's strong, and Ray's a principal writer and is a great lyricist, that we have a lot more to offer in depth-wise, and, mm-hmm. you know, we have integrity as well, so maybe that'll shine through.
Yeah. What about the album? What can we look forward to on that?
There'll be dance tracks, ballads and pop songs. Could Have Told You So is basically a pop song, but Pride was a fast, frenetic club band, really. Yeah. Had Latin influences and jazz and whatever. So you'll see some of that. And, of course, ballads like Wanted, which we have about three on the first album.
Mm-hmm. And coming up to Christmas, as we were saying before, you've got a very heavy workload ahead of you. How are you going to spend Christmas? Are you going to get back with the family?
Well, it'd be nice to, but I think we all feel that we would like to even be busier over Christmas, because that would mean the single's doing very well.
Mm-hmm.
But, I don't know, it'd be nice to sit by a log fire or something.
I mean, you know, some of us have winter hobbies. Skiing. I'm getting on to my favourite sort of skiing, and I'm not going to be able to do it this year, which is a real upset. But,
but if the album goes well, you'd probably be able to do something with the royalty next year.
Oh, it'd be years.
Yes, please.
Years after.
Well, listen, we've got a few prezzies in here. We have a 12-inch copy of the new single, Could Have Told You So. We also have a very nice presentation pack of the first single, Wanted, which included in there, what have we got in there?
We've got CD video, CD, 7-inch single, and a promotional cassette with a different version of Could Have Told You So on, which is a different mix.
Uh-huh. So you're going to sign all that up for us. We're going to give it away as a prize. Any idea on a sort of question or something like that?
We could we could ask, where did the name Halo James come from?
We've read some stuff on Halo James recently. They might know where the name's derived from, so...
have to do a bit of homework. We want to know is where the name Halo James come from.
That's
on the postcard.
That's actually a collector's item, that box Wanted.
So it's worth a few
because
bucks.
Because there was only X amount of those printed, and everybody's been trying to get hold of those.
Yeah,
so
well worth having if you are a Halo James fan. Okay, well, that's up for grabs, the Wanted presentation pack, including the 12-inch of the new single, which we're going to hear in just a minute. If you think you know where they actually got the name from, Halo James, answers on a postcard or a sealed-down envelope to the usual address, Signal Radio, Stoke-on-Trent, ST42SR. In the meantime, thank you very much for coming in, sir. Have a great Christmas, and best of luck with the single and the album.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
How would you know? truth.